people will have all these misconceptions about cerebral palsy, that they may not be able to play football or be active socially.
Once we got this kind of rare opportunity, playing for the country, travel along with the team to face other countries, I'm like a different person in life.
Football really changed my life. For somebody who is like me,
it's been a great lesson and experience. It's a great exposure for me.
What's the difference between coaching a normal football team and a cerebral palsy team? So I say there's no difference, because you are footballers to me, and they are also footballers to me.
Without football, I think I wouldn't be socializing with people. I'll just go home and just do my stuff.
This is where I started playing soccer at the age of 5. Playing on a barefoot, or using my slipper as glove, or even use school shoes to play.
Once we start the game, we have to leave all the unnecessary stuff, like, I'm not this, I'm not qualified for this.
People will be like, how did this player get so well when he's limping and stuff? Why not give a try?
Don't worry too much about your conditions or being cerebral palsy. Okay, it doesn't matter actually. We are always open for players, new players who want to join us in trainings, right, to come and enjoy the game together with us.
We are like a family now, and we know each other deep in and out.
We have a lot of activities off the pitch, like going to the swim, going for a run.
I think the team really needs a lot more players.
More players, more competition, and that will make you fight for your places in the team. We've come back from Myanmar with the silver, a fantastic achievement. And now taking this forward, we have the Para Games in Singapore coming up in 2015.
Honestly, I really cannot wait for the next Para Games.
For people also can come and watch us, in a way, come and support as a home crowd.
If there's like a lot of crowds, I'll be much more motivated and hungry for goals.